Skye Wills is a soil scientist and concentrates mostly on dynamic soil properties.
Well, I think of myself as a soil scientist as one with classic soil science training. So in the soil forming factors that we like to talk about, you know, climate, organisms, relief, the topography of the landscape, how soils change across the world and across smaller regions and landscapes. But I also think of myself as a soil scientist that works more with ecosystem sciences and with environmental applications and human management than our typical soil scientists have in the past. I'm a renaissance soil scientist, or I try to be anyway.
Skye, you mentioned several soil properties. Do you have a favorite that you study?
Well, I study a lot of properties, those that we consider dynamic or changeable with time, especially ones that change on a human timescale, things that change after repeated tilling or certain crops. So things I'm really interested in are infiltration. How fast does the water move into the soil when it rains? It's really important if you think about how the soil is going to respond to any given climate, any given rainstorm. Infiltration is going to affect the water in the soil and the water that runs off the soil. So that's really important. Soil carbon is a really big issue, both for climate change reasons, because people are concerned with how much carbon is actually in the soil, but then it also is a really good indicator of all of the other things that are going on in the soil. How much organic material has that soil incorporated? How much is it holding on to? And that affects how the physical properties will behave, how the chemical properties will behave, and the biological properties. So soil carbon is a really important soil property.
Are dynamic soil properties studied in the field or in the laboratory?
The way I use dynamic soil properties is I take field measurements that others might want to use to do an assessment of soil health, and then I also measure a version of those dynamic soil properties in the lab. And part of our job at the center is to make that connection.
Is the concept of dynamic soil properties fairly new? Has it always been around?
The idea that soil properties change with land use and management and change with really time has been around since people started thinking about what soils occur in what landscapes. But the way we use dynamic soil properties, where we're trying to systematically collect them and then give them to the public and other researchers to use, that is a new term, and it's a new conception of an old idea.
Why should farmers and landowners be interested in dynamic soil properties?
Well, landowners should be interested in dynamic soil properties because they affect how their soil can be managed. Knowing about the dynamic soil properties and the soil health that they have on site can let them know how their management system is working, how they might improve it, and how productive it will be, and how resilient it will be to change and disturbance.
What message would you like to give the American public about soil?
Soil is where all of the environmental ecosystem sciences that we're interested in, that's where they all come together. It's the nexus, it's where the rubber hits the road. You've got vegetation interacting with geology, interacting with weather and climate, interacting with management, and all of that comes together with its own special dash of soil science that makes it really important and really complicated. It's going to be hard to understand, but it's worth doing.
It's my hope that these videos have shown that the National Soil Survey Center is a world-class resource staffed by real people with real passion for their work and making a real difference.